Well, catastrophic spinal cord injuries are extremely rare in high school football, but they happen. And 15-year-old Ethan Glynn of Bloomington is living that nightmare. His positive attitude and willingness to share his experience is both eye-opening and inspiring. He's currently rehabbing at Craig Hospital in Denver, and tonight, for the first time, you're going to hear Ethan describe what happened during that game in September, and he'll also show us some surprising progress.
Ethan Glynn was super excited to play in his first freshman football game for Bloomington Jefferson in early September. But excitement in an instant changed to disbelief and heartbreaking sadness as Ethan was injured making a tackle. Ethan, with his older brother Parker next to him, opened up about that day.
Describe the play. What happened? What do you remember?
I remember all of it. I was on my blocker and I tried to throw him off me. And then my foot, I like kind of stumbled off of him into the guy with the ball. And when I went for the tackle, it was awkward. And then fell to the ground, I was on my side, and I just couldn't feel anything. I was on my side, and my arms and legs felt like they were like floating and like up. And then when they flipped me in my back, my arms felt like they were, like I was raising them up, and my legs felt like I was raising them up, but I was flat on the ground.
Ethan was rushed to the hospital and underwent three surgeries. The accident left him paralyzed from the upper bicep down.
There really is no playbook for this, is there?
No.
Tim Carlson is the Jefferson varsity coach. He was there that day. He says that one play has changed him forever.
And, you know, you ask yourself why. And there is no answer for that.
Biggest thing as a parent is you just can't fix it.
Ethan's parents, Corey and Cassidy, and Ethan himself, do not blame football for what happened that day. As Ethan says, it was a one in a billion accident.
What am I at?
You're like pretty much there.
Okay, then keep going.
The 15-year-old has chosen to move forward, accept his new reality, and fight hard to make any progress he can. And check it out, that work is paying off.
My left arm is not, like, it's like dead basically right now. But my right arm, my biceps, like, I can flex it a little bit. And then I have, like, a rotator cuff in my shoulder. I think it moves like my hand a little bit like that.
Oh, I see it.
Mm-hmm.
I see it.
Yeah.
And that's new.
Yeah. A couple of weeks.
It's the little things, right? Ethan is an amazing 15-year-old with a long road ahead. The family hopes he'll be back in Minnesota by the end of the year, and he can't wait. You can see this story and last night's with Ethan and his family on care11.com.